How to create a character writing a desk using TubbyTuff? Let's find it out! Hi, this is Gustav, the developer of TubbyTuff. Welcome to our channel! In this video, I'm going to decompose an excellent animation exercise created by our community member Jorge Andrade. Now, the interesting point about this example is the way the layers are defined to create the depth levels required to make this animation work. Finally, any scene is a composition of different elements at different distance from the camera view. So, the key when you are creating a scene like this is to split its components, placing them in the right layer in the right order. At the beginning, you will realize that creating a good composition for a scene could be a little tricky, but as usual in animation, it's all about practice. Okay, let's start analyzing our example. Understanding that this scene only shows a specific action, a good practice before animating is to create a basic sketch of what you have in mind. This drawing will allow you to recognize which are the key elements that you have to animate. At this point, take account that the first layer in the back is the static background. Usually, this whole area contains the landscape or stage of your scene. So, the first task when we are planning our project is to select which static areas of the animation will be part of the background, and which parts will be part of the other layers. In our case, the wall and all the elements in the back of the room will be part of our static background, as they never change. Other two elements that we will include in this level are the desk and the paper sheet. Although they are not at the same level than the wall, they don't change either. In fact, we could include the glass of juice as part of the background if we wish, but for some reason our animator decided to move it into other layer. Note: all the new layers to include as part of the scene must contain elements in movement or static objects that overlap other areas of the scene located behind. The key of this part of the process is to recognize the depth of every component of the view, so you can decide which elements are closer and which are far. Okay. To make easier the process, let's do a list of the parts of the scene that we want to animate. The eyes of the character. The right arm. The right hand with the pen. And the writing on the paper. As all these elements will be in movement, each one will be included in an independent layer to be animated. So let's make a list of all the layers used in this example, starting from backward to forward. The first layer over the static background includes most of the body parts of the character. It could seem a little creepy, but it's because the other parts of the body will be included in other layers. The second layer contains the pupils of the eyes. As you can notice, the movement is quite simple. The eyes just follow the hand that will be writing. The third layer includes the eyelashes, and although they are static, they require their own layer, because they overlap the pupils. Notice that now, the face of the character is complete and looks great. The fourth layer contains the writing line on the paper. This element must be included on this level, because the right hand of the character will overlap it from a coming layer. At this point, it looks like phantom writing, isn't it? The fifth layer includes the right upper arm, following a partial trajectory of rotation from one side to the other. The sixth layer contains the right forearm. As you can see, its movement is synchronized with the upper arm, emulating the movement of the arm when you are writing. The seventh layer includes the right hand with the pen, and of course, it is synchronized with the previous two layers to complete the whole arm. The last layer contains the glass of juice. As I mentioned before, it could be included in the static background, so it's not a big deal. And that's it! Now you have a very good reference about how to compose your scenes using layers. Note, It's important to say that all the elements of this project were animated using the frame-by-frame traditional technique. About how to build the elements of your character and the objects of the scene, you have two options. 1. Create all the assets of your animation using any graphic editor, as Photoshop, GIMP, or Inkscape, and then import them as PNG or JPG images into your project from the library panel. And 2. Create native objects using the drawing tools directly from Tubitube. In the case of our example, the artist used both native elements and components made using GIMP. Are you ready to try an animation exercise like this one? Okay, that's all for now. I hope you like this Tubitube. Please leave a comment saying hi, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Keep animating! See you in the next video!